Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate, Enhanced Edition, Blind. I am Amethyst Lodotari.
If none are better.
Heading, I think, to Nashkel.
You have been waylaid by enemies and must defend yourself.
But first being waylaid by enemies.
Can I help you?
Yep.
Hey, how are things going?
For the fallen!
It did say her weapon's unusable. But yet she still has it. I guess it is unusual. It's usable. It just says, doesn't say broken like a sword would.
You have need of me?
I fear I need healing.
Oh boy, yes.
Lest
you do.
I not survive. Nature for the group.
What?
Yes?
For the fallen!
Kill these stupid things. I like the sound they make when they hit the ground. Thump a thump thump. Okay. A Lynxeye gem, Jasper gem, and gold.
I can but try.
That was rather damaging.
You've a task?
Vita mortis.
Can I help you?
Alright, shall we?
I'll do my best.
Cannot save at this time. Alright, this time for real.
Father, I'm off to play.
Have a fine day, dear.
Did you remember to wash your face?
I did now.
With your hurried flight from Candlekeep barely behind you, the troubles facing the Sword Coast seem an unfamiliar blur to your fractured nerves. Gorion would not have you sit idle, however, and perhaps investigating local concerns will shed some light on your own predicament. How the iron shortage or the trouble in the Nashkel mines could possibly be linked to you, you have no idea.
Well, I hope the family and that little cinematic are going to be okay. I have arrived in Nashkel. If I'm going to look into the Iron Crisis, I should speak with someone in power who might have useful information for me. Perhaps the mayor will be of some help.
If none are better...
Look around here. Oh, wow. Well, we should probably turn in first then. Oh, is this the farm we saw in the cinematic?
This city is a blight on the landscape. Better to have let the land grow wild.
Yeah, I think so, huh?
You have... I can, but try.
What you want?
Good job.
I can, but try.
A commoner.
Hey, get out of me, will you, crummy loghead?
I'll do my best.
He'll do his best.
Chief, haven't been putting out lately.
What's wrong, son? Hey, what the bunch are you doing in me home? Get out, you hear me? Get out.
Sheep haven't been putting out lately.
The sheep haven't... Okay. I don't want to know what you mean by that.
You're a handsome bunch, ain't ya?
Please don't hurt my hubby. Please just leave us alone. All right.
You're a long-tongued lout, ain't ya?
Who are you? What do you want? Father, there's strangers in the kitchen. All right, let's get out of here.
If none are better. Can I help you?
I just realized not all of us went in there. Ah. What a nice crystal blue stream. So yeah, welcome to the 50th episode of my Let's Play of Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition. This will be an extra long episode. Because that's how I roll with the special episode 50 and 100 and such.
You have... I can, but try.
Yes?
Hurry up!
You hurry up.
Hey, how are things going?
I'll do my best.
Weather's been lousy lately.
Hi. What are you doing in my home? Get out of here before I have to hurt you. Alright.
If none are better...
Well, first... Oh, he went in the other room?
Ryan would be proud of your actions.
You think he would? I don't know if he would. A silver ring.
Can I help you?
Have a nice day.
If none are better. If none are better.
Why do you keep saying Ryan would be proud of my actions? Is this...
Hey!
Noober? Hi, I'm Noober. Nice place, huh?
Hey!
So, killed any monsters yet?
Hey!
Ever been to Baldur's Gate? I've been to Baldur's Gate.
Hey!
Ugh, I think I stepped in something.
Hey!
Everyone in town used to throw rocks at me and tell me I was annoying.
Hey,
what time is it? Ah! Everyone says, will you shut this moron up already? What does a girl have to do to get some peace and quiet around here?
Hey,
I haven't had a conversation this long, well, ever. Alright, whatever.
Hey,
what's that big weapon for? Okay, now
I'll do my
I'm
best.
Not selecting him. He did that one. And I just look around the bottom here. Oh, he's following us. How delightful. Oh, carp?
What's your tale?
I wish things were better here on the farm, but at least we're not miners. How could anything be better than this pristine pastoral setting? Aye, we could have a crop for starters. See those crusted mounds of earth? They're all left over from last year's harvest. The sun's baked them firm and hard, and the plow breaks at the very thought of trying to turn that tortured soil. My son tried pushing the new seeds in between the cracks, but I doubt anything will come of it. Come this time next year, we'll all be living in the endless slums of Azcatla. So yes, I wish things were better in this here pristine and pastoral setting. Oh, nice talking to you then. I think we'll just clear out this section here. A moo cow. See, this whole area up here, I don't know about. There might be baddies there. I'd rather explore it during the day, to be honest, and after we've gotten some rest. He's been in there, and he didn't like us being in there. Should we look around the bottom some more? On the south area. Thinking it's safe over here. Bridge over non-troubled waters. Edwin?
Go no further. I require the services of your group.
Yes, they will do nicely.
Huh. Is that what he's thinking? I guess he's thinking, is this what I have to work with? Pathetic, but it will have to do. I am Edwin, and I would have you work with me. Work for me is but the simple chore of killing the witch Dinah here. Do you accept the task? Why would you have this woman dead? Am I to kill her without knowing? Frankly, yes. It is no concern of yours. You need but perform the act with no questions. What is your answer? I am not willing to kill without sufficient reason. Come with us, and if we find your Dinah here, we will decide how to proceed. A wise decision. One can never be too cautious dealing with her kind. And he thinks, yes, I shall watch for her carefully. All right, so we've got Edwin. Oh, and he leveled up and gained a bunch of spells. Larlock's Minor Drain, Horror, Melf's Acid Arrow, and...
Again you disturb me.
Mirror Image. I did not encounter him when I played. This, going forward, this is going to be blind, at least for a little while. I think I did fight the half-ogres, I just don't remember where I fought them. And...
Perhaps this group needs not quite as much help as I thought.
I think, I think I was in like a sunken lighthouse or something like that. And maybe another Exvart village. I think it by like a waterfall. Can't remember. It's like tucked away in a corner. Hmm. Other than that, all blind. From here on in. As far as I know, anyway. Edwin! He has just a regular quarterstaff. Edwin's amulet. This is Edwin's birthright inlaid with his family stone. He can memorize one extra wizard spell of each level. Only usable by Edwin. Oh, that means we won't want it. Edwin angrily knocks your hand aside. It's a memento. Wait. Keep your hands off this amulet. It's a memento of... Of May? Of Thay? I don't know what that's saying. Memento of... Of Mai? And you shall not touch it. Mm-hmm. He has armor class 10. Pretty bad. 6 hit points. Oh, wow. Lawful evil. Here we go. He has a popular reputation. And he can level up. Very good. Intelligence. Constitution. Not so good with anything else. When asked about his past, Edwin sneers that he has no intention of revealing such information, and that it is none of your business. He further states that you are lucky enough to simply share his company, and then mutters something about leaving whenever he wishes. He obviously cares little for the camaraderie of others, and seems to take more pleasure in speaking to himself than in interacting with the party. His attire brazenly displays the colors of the Red Wizards of Thay, though why a member of that organization would come so far west is puzzling. Edwin does not seem forthcoming with any information. So that's what he was saying. Is a memento of Thay. It's cut off there. So I guess another level 1 spell and 2 level 2 spells. 9 additional hit points. Alright. Now I got 15 hit points. Use level 3.
What is it? A simple matter.
Edwin has been pensive of late. More so than usual. How would I know that? Perhaps now would be a good time to ask about him. Tell me of Thay, Edwin. What's it like? What? You have not heard the name Odisseran before? Ignorant lout. My kin is the Thorchian of Sir Thay, a head of a sizable army and a supreme wizard. Though he is no longer officially a red wizard, few are able to survive an encounter with him. Oh. I thought I was asking about a region or a group. What's it like? You seem to know so much. How'd you become so powerful? Thay provides patronage for every red wizard, and a man of my skill and talent passes by no opportunity, especially in the land so ripe with possibilities. You talk about Edwin's problems and hopes in a friendly and kind manner, in hopes of making Edwin confide in you. I do what I do for my own elevation, and, by extension, for the glory of Thay. So, Edwin, can you tell me more about yourself? You cannot wriggle information out of me. He thinks as if they have the intelligence for such a task. That's it. tempted. Yeah. Be careful with your spells. I don't need any accidents in my group. What? You doubt my magic? Ungrateful wretch. Why do I even suffer your company? Alright, I guess we're done here.
I can but try.
People. Mrs. Blackwood, Tom, and Sarah.
Hey, friend.
Ah, I'm sorry. We won't stand in your way. Come on, children. You look as if something is troubling you. Can I help you in any way? Ah, don't you worry. Sarah, leave Tom alone. Nope, I already said you can't have it. Well, it's children, you know. They always... Tom, don't you start it now. For heaven's sake. Thank you very much, but I don't want to waste your time. The kids don't talk.
What? Such menial tasks. Hey, friend.
Yes, my dear? I couldn't help but overhear your sighing. It seems you need someone who would babysit your children, don't you? Well, yes. That is actually true. You see, I have a very important appointment where I most surely can't take any children along. You aren't asking because you know someone appropriate by any chance. Really? We're going to babysit kids? I am a stranger, but seeing you in such a need, maybe I could take care of your children. You would? I mean, it wouldn't take longer than half an hour. They're really lovely, only a bit... Well, they keep you busy. Well, I think I would love to accept your offer. You seem such a decent person. I've heard a lot of good about you lately. Tell me when you are ready, and I will leave the kids in your care. It won't take much longer than a half hour, I promise. Just be prepared. Well, you won't have much time to do anything else during that time. Really? Okay, I'll be ready right away. Sarah, Tom, would you stay with me for a moment while your mommy is away? You have no idea how much your kindness is helping me. Ah, before I forget, here is Tom's bottle and his toy. Just give it to him if he feels sad. Here is Sarah's bottle and her doll. Here is her coat. She refused to wear it. Maybe you can talk some sense into her. Ah, and some sweets. Usually I don't give them that much, but... Well, it'll keep them busy. For a while, at least. Children, you better behave yourselves. Mommy will be back soon. Bye, my darlings. Thank you so much indeed. I'll expect you to stay in this area. Just, you know, to be sure. I agreed to babysit two children in Nashkel. The mother should be back in a half hour and expects us to meet in the same area. I shouldn't leave the area to prevent any misunderstandings.
Ooh, you smell.
Hey. Why is Mommy going away? What the hell's that? Looks like a corpse. Mommy? Tom says. I want my doll. Bear! That meant he wants to have his bear. Bear! And I want my doll. Here you go. A bear and a doll.
You funny looking.
Eats. Yes, for me too. Eats. Me too. Eats. You don't get all of them. Mommy said they're for both of us. Eats. Are you talking about sweets? Mommy said the sweets are for us both. Hey, what the hell? You want to have sweets? Here you go. Lost an item. Candy, sweets, sweets. Wait a minute, did you take them all? You'll get sick.
You smell.
You stop telling me I smell. Tom had more than me. You see what Tom is doing with his sweets? Tom says, eek! Tom, do not put the sweets in the dirt before eating them. Eek! See what he's doing now? Tom, you shouldn't do this. I said not to put the sweets into the dirt, Tom. Tom, Mommy wouldn't like it. Tom, are you listening? He ate them all now. That he did, indeed.
Ooh,
You smell.
Mommy said you shouldn't do this, Tom. Get your bear back up here, and quick. Nah. Mommy wouldn't like this at all, Tom. Nah. No, you won't get my doll. Buh. Get your hands off my doll. Buh. No, no. Tom, Sarah, stop it. Sarah's bottle. Yeah, one at a minute to get into inventory. This is Sarah's bottle that Mrs. Blackwood gave to you. It is covered with traces of a sticky liquid combined with the obligatory sand and dirt. You are sure you don't want to drink out of it. Sarah's coat. Oh, wrong person. Tom's bottle. They're both covered with a sticky liquid. Wonderful. Now while we're looking through our stuff, the kids disappear.
Ooh, you smell.
My doll is the nicest doll in the world. Don't you think so? Sarah, please put on your coat. Mommy knitted the shoes herself. She's just ignoring me. We bought the wool from Aunt Helena. Do you know Aunt Helena? Aunt Helena isn't really my aunt. I don't like her. She has a funny nose. Her nose looks like a red dragon's nose. Have you ever seen a red dragon? Would you listen to my answer? It's all red and red. I don't like her nose, but the wool is nice. She gave me blue-colored wool as a gift. Mommy said she only did that so we'd come back again. Do you know what Mommy knitted out of the blue wool? The scarf? Out of the blue wool, she made a little pillow. But Oscar ate it. Do you know Oscar? Sarah, please put on your coat. Oscar is the old fat dog from the other house. Mommy said he thought it was a cookie. No, Tom, you can't have one. We already ate all the sweets. Please put on your coat. Why don't you ask Tom? Every time it's me. Tom is already wearing his coat, Sarah. It's too warm. No, it's not. Put on a coat, Sarah. You are not my mommy. That is right, but I'm taking care of you while your mommy is away. Put on the coat, Sarah. Drink something. Here are your bottles. Oh, I know. Yes, drink something, Sarah. See, Tom already did. I don't like it. It is water, I suppose. You have to drink something, Sarah. It's healthy. Oh, I know. I don't like it. Oh, I know. It's too warm. Just be quiet and wait.
Ooh, you smell.
I'm thirsty. I offered you just something to drink not 2 minutes ago. Now take your bottles, both of you. I don't like this. I want juice. Juice, would you buy me juice? Two, Tom says. I asked first. Sorry, but it'll be your bottles for today. No juice. But I want juice. Tom, watch how you're holding your bottle. It's dripping. Where did Mommy go? I'm sure she'll be back soon. It can't take much longer. Mommy, where is Mommy? As I said, I don't know, but she'll be back soon. Bottle dripping. Tom, your water makes puddles on the floor. Well, this is the ground. Look! Tom's making a mess. Tom's making a mess. Some water on the ground. No need to worry. Eek! Don't point it at me. Oh, Tom, don't shake your bottle. He spilled it all on my shoes. And his bear. It doesn't matter. The bottle is empty now. And his trousers. Tom is wet. Let's hope that was the water.
You funny looking.
Thanks, Mommy, he says.
Ooh, you smell.
Can I have a look at your weapons? What do you want to see? What is this? No, Sarah, these are not for you. What do you use that for? Don't touch it, Sarah. These are not toys. What's that shiny thing there? Are you by any chance listening? Is it okay Tom is holding it in his hands? Gods, Tom, give that back. How could I miss how you've taken this? Rah! Tom, it's all right. This is mine and you have your bear. Wah! Tom, be quiet. Mommy would not like this at all, Tom. Wah! Eek, he's pulling my hair. Children, children, gods. I'll tell Mommy, Tom. No need, it's all right now. Is she coming back? Who's this?
Ooh, you smell.
Tom is wet. It was a beggar.
Ooh, you smell.
Mrs. Blackwood. Ah, here you are. I am so grateful. Thank you again, dear stranger. Sarah, Tom, I'm back. I see you didn't manage to make Sarah wear her coat either. Don't worry, that's how she is. So how about my reward? Reward? I didn't... See, I don't have any money. I had to go and talk to their dad in private. He will pay for our transfer to my family in Am. That's all. Bastard. Oops, I'm sorry. Children, that is a bad word. Don't you ever use it. Could I offer you something else? Private services. Don't worry, really. I see you have enough problems as it is. Farewell. I thank you. You've been a great help. Even though it might be hard to understand why I can't take them along to their dad. I'll tell everyone how helpful you've been. Come along, children. Reputation increased by one. What a pity they've gone, Imowen says. I was thinking about bribing Tom into giving me some of his next sweets. Edwin says, a reward wouldn't have been enough for this nuisance. Soladium it would take. I don't know what that means. You did that really well, Sapphire. Ahem, she giggles. Sapphire, I admire your patience, Kalia says. Maybe as wise before having children of our own. What do you say, Jahira? Emmeline says, by the way, Sapphire, have you got some leftover candy there? All right, that was gone.
Perhaps this group needs not quite as much help as I thought.
The mother came to collect her two children. Everything went well, as far as I can tell. It's been an experience. They took the coats.
I can stand no more.
This idiocy must stop. I'll be forced to take my leave. What idiocy? Because we helped them?
I'll do my best.
Mrs. Brunstein?
Somebody help me!
Calm yourself, good woman. Tell me what happened. I will try, good man. My son, my beloved Aaron, is gone. Please, you must find him. He means everything to me. Where was he last seen? He left for a mountain trip with his fiancée a few days ago. They were going to have a picnic, and I think he wanted to propose to her. But they never came back, so Baron gathered a company of farmers and searched the mountains. They have... Oh no, it's too awful. Who is Barlin? Oh, Baron, sorry. Baron is the ranger who led the search for Aaron and Marina. He should be in the temple right now. He surely can help you. What have they found? They found Marina's body. Someone slew her and threw her down the waterfall. The poor child. She was so young, and there were signs of monsters everywhere. No one dared to go follow them, being just farmers. Oh, please, find my boy. Can you tell us anything else? If you want to know more, then talk to Baron. He's probably in the temple right now. What can you offer us as payment? I do not have any valuables beside my mother's silver necklace. I promise you, you can have it, if only you bring back my son. Alright, we're going to look for your son. Oh, you make me so happy, sir. Sir. Please hurry. Aaron's such an emotional and sensitive boy. He surely will be dreadfully scared. And talk to Baron in the temple, for he can certainly tell you further details. I agreed to look for Aaron Brunstein. The boy went for a mountain trip with his fiancée and was never seen again. Perhaps the ranger Baron in the temple in Nashkel can help us.
Perhaps this group needs not quite as much help as I thought.
Oh, I thought this was a house.
Easy as pie.
Imowen, you're looking, thinking about pickpocketing people?
I'll do my best.
I have things to do. Why not being sitting on me duffer talking to you?
We'd be proud citizens of Arm here. Not pussy fools like you northerners. I thought this town was called Nashkel. You've lived a sheltered life if you never heard of the great trading nation of Arm. Nashkel here marks its northernmost boundary, though that may change before too long. Mark my words, there'll be Armian soldiers lining the streets of Baragos by winter if those devils from Baldur's Gate don't stop sabotaging our iron.
Hello, pal.
If you've come to town looking for work, you may as well pack up and go back to whence you came. Our mines to the east are soon to be closed down. No one's willing to work there anymore, except the foolhardy and the desperate. Something's down in those mines. Something evil.
I have things to do. Why not being sitting on me duffer talking to you?
The guard is pathetic. Why, if I had my way, that brage would have been quartered by now. He's just a man like any other. A blade delivered in the proper fashion will drop him as simply as his victims. That's right. Let's see if we can deliver Brage's remains, which I guess we're carrying around with us. There wasn't anything to collect from that battle. Not even his own guards have been able to find Captain Brage. Volo?
Yes, the, a tab. Another ale, young miss. I'll be sure to have your funds ready.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I think he's the ones who make these, traveling guides. This is another Volo. Greetings, fellow traveler, for I see by your guard that you do not call this place home. Sit with me a while and enjoy the atmosphere of this fine air while we recount tales of lands far and far-seeming. I have wandered the width and breadth of Faerûn, but yet have I to find such hospitality as that of a simple country festival. It's a shame that the festivities are marred by the events as of recent, though they certainly put up a brave face, do they not? You look confused, so perhaps you know not of the local trouble that continues to vex the most gracious people of Nashkel. I do. I don't know why I look confused. If you have just arrived, I could, for the price of an ale and an ear, relate what I know. Shall I tell you of their mining difficulties, or relate the tale of their unfortunate commander of the guard? The tale of the guard sounds interesting. Please, do tell. I hear that Commander Brage of the Omnian Guard has been missing for some weeks now, following a strange altercation in his behavior. Where once he was a well-thought-of family man, he has since turned to senseless mayhem, affecting a rampage the likes of which I have never heard. His fellow soldiers noted nothing out of sorts that could trigger such a transformation. But one notable item seems relevant. If not for the iron shortage, it would have gone unnoticed. But prior to his mad rage, the commander procured a new sword. The importance of this information, I have no way of verifying. I have heard as much from common rumors about the street outside. Your tale is but a long-winded version. There's no cause to be rude. It'd be good for you to leave. Oh, jeez. Rumor from Volo. I hear that Commander Brage of the Omnian Guard has been missing for some weeks now, following a strange alteration in his behavior, where once he... the thought of family man... The importance of this information I have no way of verifying. I have this remain, so...
'Tis surprising what one can learn at a simple country fair, hmm?
Well, hello again, my inquisitive friend. I trust you enjoying the local color. I wonder, have you come to hear more about my journeys? If you would relate what troubles have been plaguing the Mayans, I would appreciate it. The word is that all across the expanse of Sword Coast, from the Cloud Peaks to Baldur's Gate, an ore shortage is severely crippling local trade. Bandits, purportedly both human and demi-human, raid caravans, whilst ore reaching its destination becomes brittle and useless following smelting, strangely afflicted by an odd iron-weakening plague. As though this were not cause for alarm in itself, production of the mines outside of Nashkel has fallen, with the substantially lower yields being blamed on nervous workers. Mysterious disappearance of several miners have set the whole area on edge, where something must shift the balance to one side or another. An interesting story, to be sure. Well met, Volo, and good luck on your journeys. And you as well. I'm quite certain our paths will cross again. Okay, that's pretty much word for word.
Good on you if you saved the day.
So that's the bartender. Got this commoner.
You need something, stranger.
I paid 35 gold for a sword from Baragos, and it rotted in my hands. What can disease metal so? Has your gear done the same? Even if you got your blades out of some dank old dungeon, just bringing them near tainted metal makes them weak. Seems like only magic weapons don't degrade, but who has those? No one I know. I have a couple.
Need something, stranger?
You new to town, eh? Well, if I were you, I'd just turn around and leave. Ever since the monsters started killing in the iron mines, this town's been cursed. Just a few weeks back, our guard commander lost his mind and slaughtered his family. No good to stay here, trust me.
I have things to do. Why not be in sitting on me duffer talking to you?
I'll not go down to the mines again. Tain't natural what's down there. I just don't understand how adventuring fools like you go and put yourselves in harm's way. I do whatever I can to avoid trouble. People are afraid of the mines, but they're not sure what is there.
I have things to do. Why not be in sitting on me duffer talking to you?
You people look new to Nashkel. I assume you've come to see the fair. It's really too bad about the troubles we've been having here lately, because it's kind of ruined the whole mood at the fair. Where is this fair located? The fair? It's just east of Nashkel. There ain't too many people there, though. A bouncer. Talk to this guy. This is another commoner.
Hello, pal.
Okay, same thing. How about this guy walking?
I have things to do. Why not be in sitting on me duffer talking to you?
It's like saying that, don't you? I hear tell of adventurers in town, but they're all talk and no action. If you see him, give him a kick and tell him to get moving. We need help, and we need it fast. Okay, come here, Edwin. I'll kick you. All right, let's talk to the bouncer. I can't talk to the bouncer. Let's talk to the bartender.
I got some cheap beer for ya.
Beware the woods to the west, friend, for I hear tell of ogres and madmen. So would you like a drink? Yes. Okay, we can't sleep here. So mead.
You want some whiskey?
If all those blasts of review cut my business in half, I'll take him for a chat out back when next I see him. Would you like to drink? Nope. What about this bouncer? Oh, I go around there to talk to him? I don't speak, I guess. I guess we're done in here. What's this place? Belching Dragon Tavern.
You have need if none are better.
I'm just gonna look up here a little bit. Not going that far. I have no idea if there's anything lurking out in these wooded areas. Oh, more town.
Hey! Get out of me way, you crummy loghead!
I hate this stupid town. Nothing ever happens around here. A person could die just from the boredom. What we need around here is a good war. That'll spice things up. Good for the economy.
Yes? Such menial tasks. Yes?
If the guard cannot protect the miners, the least they could do is find my husband's body. He's been missing for days now, and I just keep getting the runaround. Someone ought to go down there and show them how to take care of business. Someone is killing men in the mines. Omnian guards are unable to stop it. Nashkel's store. Let's go over here and talk to these people.
Stand away, citizen!
Identify yourselves! Bardolin? I am Sapphire, and this is my band of fellow adventurers. I hear that this is a troubled region of late. Allow me to put ourselves at your disposal during our stay here. If you're seeking to resolve troubles, welcome. If you're seeking to cause them, kindly take it elsewhere. Things are not good here, Sapphire. I want to hear it from him. What things aren't good? All I have heard are rumors and vague suspicions. Aye, what is good around here anymore? Our iron is rotten, and there is talk of demons in the mines. The lower levels have been all but abandoned until this crisis passes. And then there is the question of Captain Brage. Ach, they have stripped him of that title, but I use it yet. He killed his wife and children in a rage one night, and all who saw him. Then he tore himself away and headed for the hills. He is out there still, and still we mourn, as much for him as those he's taken. Fire on you now. You brought tears to the eyes of a soldier. You did that to yourself. Apparently the iron coming out of the Nashkel mine is rotten, and there are demons in the lower levels. Furthermore, a member of the guard named Brage went on a murderous rampage and is still loose. Nashkel is a troubled city indeed. We might have already found his body.
Hey! Get out of me way, you crummy loghead!
I am not a loggerhead. What are these people? War commoners. Taris?
Hey!
Hello!
Get out of me way, you crummy loghead!
Move aside and I'll be on my way. I have no time to waste on idle blathering. Hard enough making a living without you slowing me down.
Hey! Get out of me way, you crummy loghead!
This terrace hangs over there.
Yes? Hmm?
See? Such feats are easy when you learn to focus their energies through the light of Selune.
Huh. Rasaad. Are you some sort of circus performer?
No. But I understand why you might think so. My name is Rasaad. I am merely demonstrating some of the ways in which we Sun Soul monks reflect our spiritual light through physical activity.
Hmm.
May I tell you more about the Order of the Sun Soul?
Please do.
The Order of the Sun Soul was founded during the time of...
Aye, what are you supposed to be then? Some sort of kick puncher? Come on, take a poke at me, I dare you.
I have come not to fight, but to demonstrate a few...
Oh, so that's how it is, eh? You prance about, pretending to be some sort of odd man, but you're just a coward, right?
I wouldn't provoke him.
I am not afraid to defend myself, but I do not seek out conflict without purpose. Instead, I wish to share the light of the Moon Maiden.
Oh, I get it. You're some kind of simpering priest, just pretending you knows how to fight, but really just begging for coins, yeah?
A Sun Soul monk uses mind, body, and spirit in equal portions, but not to prove his martial superiority. Rather, he seeks to better the lives of those around him.
Yeah, yeah, save it for temple school, boy. If you're not gonna fight nobody, I won't waste any more time on you.
Good for you, Rasaad. I admire a man who stands up for his principles, even in the face of ignorance.
I thank you. It is not always easy. In truth, I enjoy a good fight if it is to improve my skills or to defend a just cause. Fighting that man would have enlightened no one. You seem like someone who would appreciate the tenets of my order. May I tell you more about Saluni and the Sun Soul monks?
Tell me why you worship Saluni.
Of the inheritors of Amonito's power, Saluni is the most ardent foe of spiritual darkness. After all, she is the bright opposite of Shah, the mistress of the night. The Moon Maiden's reflected radiance inspires us to shine our inner light upon those in need. In the face of lies, we offer truth. In the face of hatred, we offer compassion.
You don't go door to door with this stuff, I hope.
What more would you like to know?
Tell me more about the Order of the Sun Soul.
The Order of the Sun Soul was founded in the days of ancient Netheril. Then it was called the Brotherhood of the Sun, and its members dedicated themselves to the sun god, Amonito.
Amonito?
With the fall of Netheril, Amonito vanished. Some believe his power now resides in other gods. Different factions of my order turn to them, most to Lathander, some to Saluni, and a very few to Suni.
It's actually one of the components I have in my computer system. It's a monitor.
My sect of the Order reveres Saluni, the Moon Maiden. What more would you like to know?
Never been one for monk characters, so I'm gonna pass up him joining us. I mean, we might have a quest to do, but I'll check back with him later. That's enough for now. Farewell.
Farewell. Until we meet again, may you walk in moonlight.
Why, thank you.
I will show you justice!
I thought he was attacking us for a second. Alright, let's talk to...
I will show you justice!
Nashkel in. Let's talk to, Taris.
Oh, you haven't seen a man about him. This tall and this wide, have you? That lout?
I'm sorry I can't help you? Why? Why can't I help him?
I will show you justice.
Can I help her, rather? I think it'd be a good idea to get some rest.
I will show you justice.
I'm gonna show them justice.
It may be a touch unladylike, but I'm gonna slit your throat, I am.
What? Neira? Just fancy my luck seeing you stroll in here at Baldur's Day. I expected a hunt and a chase from the description, but who am I to argue easy coins in the purse? May the Lord of Shadows guide you swiftly to your death.